I'm going to be sharing with you guys my October favorites. I have a lot of random and beauty and some song favorites, which are my favorite thing to share with you guys. I love doing the songs at the end. So stay tuned for that. But I want to start out with the beauty products because I have quite a few shower-esque products that I'd like to share with you guys that I'm pretty pumped about that I've turned to really, really love. Starting out with the very first thing is this Frosted Pumpkin Bakery Collection Shower Gel. This is the Ulta line of stuff, which I have never tried. Ulta does have a cosmetic line, and I didn't know that they also had a shower products line. So they had this shower gel, and I actually didn't notice it. My boyfriend and me were in Ulta, and he knows that I love pumpkin, anything pumpkin. It calls my name, it's totally me. And he found this Frosted Pumpkin Shower Gel. And I'm like, I'm not really into shower gels. I've never really been into shower gels that much. I just wash my body with like Dove soap and it's like, that's it. But shower gel that smells like pumpkin, I thought would just be really kind of fake. You know, like when you smell something that's like, say a soap from Bath & Body Works, I feel like their soaps, most of them that are supposed to smell like cranberry pumpkin or pumpkin spice or something like that, they smell really like fake and just perfumey and weird and soapy. And that's usually how shower gels come off to me too, just a really weird smell and I don't like it. But I took a chance on this and I smelt it in the store and I about passed out because I was so excited that I finally found a shower gel that smells like what it says. This does not have a soapy smell to it whatsoever. I love the way it like lathers on my body. I just put it on my loofah, wash my body with it. It has coconut oil in it, it has shea butter and vitamin E, yeah, and ginger. So it's just, oh my gosh, I don't know what it is. It just smells so good, like you could just eat or drink this stuff. It's amazing. And there's no soapy smell to this whatsoever. It legit tastes, jeez Brittany, you can't eat this, okay? It legit smells like frosted pumpkin, like a frosted pumpkin cupcake or something. Which not everybody really wants to smell like frosted pumpkin cupcake, but I do, so I purchased this from Ulta. Now, they were having a deal on the Ulta products. I think it was buy two, get two free. So I got this baked pumpkin lotion along with it, and same with the lotions. They have coconut oil in them, vitamin A, B5, and E, and coconut oil. Yeah, I think I said coconut oil, but again, smells just like baked pumpkin, like a baked pumpkin bread. Just smells really, really good. I'm really into like bakery type things. Like I have a lotion down there that's sweet from Paris and it smells like a macaroon, or like over there I have another apple cranberry pumpkin one down on my dresser. I'm like, I'm pointing over here, but I have my tripod sitting on my dresser right now, so I have some stuff on there. But I'm just really into like bakery type scents, and these just smell so good. And they work really well. This lotion doesn't give you any, it doesn't leave you greasy or oily or anything, which is surprising because, I don't know, I just never gave the Ulta brand a try, and so far I'm very impressed. Another thing that I've been absolutely loving this month is this Cup of Warmth Shea Butter Body Scrub from Bath & Body Works. I was so shocked to see that these came out. I first of all love the scent of this one. This is Vanilla Chai Toasted Biscotti, Delicious Sips of Comfort, and then it has shea butter. This just smells so amazing. Luckily, they had like 4 or 5 set up around the sink, because in Bath & Body Works, when you go in there, you could like wash your hands with a bunch of their products. They had the new ones of these sitting out, and I tried this one. I fell in love the moment I put this on my hands. This does go all over my body for an exfoliator, and it leaves my body smelling really good, like vanilla chai, which I love. And it just makes my skin feel really, really smooth and like kind of buttery. It's very good for when I want to self-tan, which let me just point out, you guys are probably going to notice my hands in this video. It's so embarrassing. So I bought a self-tanning machine, which I probably could say that's in my favorites too, but I don't want to get it because it's huge. It's a real self-tanning machine, and it's like the ones from the shop that you actually pay like 50 bucks to go get self-tanned. Well, I decided to invest in my own, and I'm going to be like having people whenever they want. I'm just going to kind of make my own business out of it and do it for a lot cheaper than $45, but with the same machine. And if anybody needs like prom self-tanning, or you know, party, or if somebody just wants to be self-tanned, because hey, I do all the time, so that's why I invested in one. But yesterday I had a little mishap and I spilled the bottle all over my hands and I didn't realize it and I left it on my hands and now I'm stuck with orange hands, so that's no fun and it looks really extremely weird, so just excuse that. I had a self-tanning mishap problem last night, but yeah, I guess that's kind of part of my favorites too. It's an awesome machine. I totally think that investing in a self-tanning machine is worth it. They charge you so much money to go into the shop and get it done just by somebody doing it, but when you actually order your own and set it up at your house, you can do it whenever you want and all you have to buy is the bottles of self-tanner and you're done. So yeah, just don't spill it and make your hands orange like this, because it's not so cute and it looks very strange. So yeah, just I definitely wanted to tell you guys that because I'm sure some of you guys will probably notice in this video my hands look crazy. But back to the cup of warmth, I love it. It's an awesome exfoliator. It leaves my skin super smooth and I highly recommend you guys go and check these out in your local Bath & Body Works. Now onto shampoo. I wanted to give something kind of new a try because my hair tends to get tired of using the same shampoo all the time. It kind of just looks dead and flat. My hair already is pretty flat because I have thin hair, and well, not necessarily thin, I guess you could say it's fine is what a lot of people like to call it, and I wanted to get something that could maybe thicken it a bit. I heard a lot of things about keratin and I thought I would give this Tresemme Keratin Smooth shampoo and conditioner. I did get the conditioner and I do like both of them a lot, so I did want to include this in my favorites video, but it just really cleanses and like makes my hair really, really smooth. I heard it's not good to use keratin every single day, but I don't wash my hair every day anyways, so I don't need to really worry about that. But when I do use this, this is the only shampoo that I'm currently using and it's really good. It's amazing. I love that it leaves the scent on my hair, which is a huge thing for me. I want my hair to still smell good after I get out of the shower. So this stuff has just been really good. Moving on to a face mask. This is by a brand that I swear by. This is Peter Thomas Roth Therapeutic Sulfur Mask. It's an acne treatment mask. It has 10% sulfur. It claims to clear acne, oil absorb, deep pore cleansing, soothing aloe, purifying kaolin, which is like a clay, and it has bentonite clay as well, which are really good for the skin, and it just really seeps in your pores and pulls everything out along with the sulfur for the acne. I've been breaking out really bad on my chin. I don't know if it's the change in my diet. I did kind of sporadically go vegan and then now I'm sporadically not vegan. I do try and lay off of dairy because just dairy is never good for anybody's skin or hormones or body, especially if you're a woman. So I do try to stay away from dairy a lot, but I do eat meat again. It was my own kind of digestive issues that I was having. No, I do not think that everybody should have meat in their diet, or I don't recommend anybody eat meat or saying that you can't live without meat. No, that's not it at all. I just had to eat meat again because of my digestive system and I needed it. So I was lacking protein. I was getting it from other sources, but it just wasn't working out. So I know I just went on a random tangent from a face mask. How does that happen? I swear, I have the attention span of a squirrel. It is crazy. Okay, so back to the mask. It's amazing. Like I said, I've been breaking out really bad. It might be the change in my diet, not sure, but it's only my chin, like always, and this mask has actually done really great things for my skin. It looks like this. It's like a white clay-like thing. Kind of smells funky. It's definitely the sulfur, but if it works, I don't really care what it smells or looks like. Now onto some makeup products. I know, where the heck are the makeup products, Brittany? This is a foundation that I am wearing right now. I just recently got it. Pretty much been wearing it the entire month of October. This is the EX1 Invisiwear Liquid Foundation. I have it in the shade F200. Currently wearing it right now. I am self-tanned with my self-tanning machine. My face might look a tiny bit different because I didn't really try the foundation when I was self-tanned with that machine. So yeah, but it seems to be matching okay. It looks okay. I really like this foundation. It covers well. The lasting power is really good. I may do a review on this, so if you guys want to see that, let me know down below in a comment. The next two products are liquid lipsticks. I have been really loving these two shades by Anastasia Beverly Hills. This one is in the shade Sepia, which I am currently wearing, and this one is in the shade Milkshake, which I'm currently wearing. So Yeah, I like to mix liquid lipsticks a lot. I love the kind of ombre look. These two together have been my favorite the entire month of October. And like I said, I'm wearing both of them right now and I love the way they look on top of each other. They're so fun. Like, liquid lipsticks are so easy to just put on top and kind of make that ombre effect. It's extremely easy. You don't have to go in with all these like lip liners, and I see a lot of people doing that. All you do, put one on and then put another one on and just dab it. You got yourself some ombre lips. All right, moving on to random favorites. I have some really cute random favorites, starting out with this coffee creamer. This is the sugar-free peppermint mocha coffee creamer. Oh my gosh, guys. Okay, so if anybody knows me, my favorite Starbucks drink of all time is the peppermint mocha with soy milk. I get that all the time when I go. But I wanted to give this baby a try and make my own coffee at home using the peppermint mocha because I was just spending way too much every single morning going to Starbucks. So I decided to invest in a good coffee, a yummy creamer, and a nice mug that does not taste like plastic that I could take coffee in every single morning. So I found all three of those and I really like to share them with you. So first thing being this peppermint mocha coffee creamer. It's only 15 calories, 1 gram of fat for a tablespoon of this stuff. I kind of just pour it on in for however much I want and got yourself some yummy peppermint mocha coffee. The two things going along with that, I've been using this Donut Shop Vanilla Cream Puff K-Cup. Amazing. Donut Shop, I think, is by far one of the best K-Cup brands I have ever tried. There's some in my Amazon cart right now that I'll let you know next month if I like, because they haven't came yet. But if I do like them, they'll probably be in my November favorites. This one so far has definitely been my favorite. I love the Donut Shop coffees. They're really good. I'm not a huge coffee person when it comes to, like, I like having a flavored coffee. I don't want to just have a K-Cup that's just medium roast coffee. Like, that's not really for me. I like having the flavors, and this vanilla cream puff one is really good. And then I did get lucky and I found this Kate Spade mug that's actually pretty good sized and does not make my coffee, or any drink for that matter, taste like plastic. I have had the worst luck with really cute plastic cups that I've tried to put my coffee in or any kind of drink, and it makes it taste so disgusting. I don't know what it is. I've tried every kind of thermal, metal, plastic. I've had bad luck with it. But so far with this cup, it has not given me that problem. So thank you for this Kate Spade mug. I got this at Macy's, I'd say 2-3 weeks ago. And I love the size. It doesn't make my coffee taste bad. So this is what I've been taking with me every single morning with those two things in it. Now, I have to mention some goodies along with it because I'm a foodie and I always have food in my favorites video, I feel like. The first thing I've been loving, like, almost every single night is these Ocho Peanut Butter Milk Chocolates. They're organic candy bar, but I got them at Safeway, and they're just really, really good. They taste like an entire Reese's, but they have no artificial sweeteners or flavors or anything like that, and it's organic. And then another thing that is probably not so healthy, because, well, most things that taste really, really good are not healthy, let's just be honest. These are my favorite candy right now. These white chocolate Kit Kats are amazeballs. Like, I seriously love these things. They're unwrapped mini crisp wafers in cream. These ones I really like because you can just be lazy and open up the bag like this, and then you just pick it out and you don't even have to unwrap it, like I'm gonna do right now. A perfume favorite in a long time, and I really wanted to mention this one because I did recently just purchase this. I've been wanting it for a really long time, but it is very expensive. This is the Versace Eros perfume, and it is amazing. I think this perfume is probably one of my favorites out of every single one that I own. Right now, this is just perfect for this time of year. It has a very musty but sweet smell, which is all me. I love very, like, hardcore perfumes, but they're not too overbearing, but still have that kind of sweet, sultry smell, and totally has a mix of all of that. This stuff smells so freaking good. Go to Macy's and just go smell it. You'll know exactly what I'm talking about, because you guys know I'm probably not the best at explaining what stuff smells like, but I love it so much. I did get the biggest bottle that it comes in. I also got the rollerball and the lotion, so that tells you right there I'm obsessed with this stuff. And I'm going to go on to one of my favorite parts of the video. It is my song favorites. First song I've been really, really loving is this song by Jacquees, which is an amazing singer. I swear, if I ever get married, this guy's songs are going to be played at my wedding. I love all of his songs, especially his CD, which is called Jacquees 19. This song is Won't Turn It Down, featuring Chris Brown. I just love his voice. Guys, that is the end of my October favorites. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to leave a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more videos. I make videos every single week, and don't forget to follow me on my Instagram, my Twitter, so definitely follow me on one of those. I love you guys so much, and I will see you in my next video. Bye. God, my hands look really bad. Bye. Ah.